Good morning, everyone. Today we are all going to present our topic. It's HTML5. I am Sai Charan. This is Akhil, and this is Ram Kumar. This is Koti, and now I'm going to discuss about HTML5, how it evolved in the world, and what is HTML and what is HTML5. HTML5 is the upgraded version of HTML4, and how it gets started and history of HTML5. And what are the new elements which are in HTML5, and what are the new input elements, structural elements, semantic elements, and many input tags which are all coming into like new inline elements in HTML5. And we are all going to discuss about advantages of HTML5, differences between HTML4 and HTML5, and what are all the websites using HTML5. And what are all the browsers which will be supported by HTML5, and what are all the HTML5 tags and the references? Can you please? And HTML is an hypertext markup language. It is not a programming language. It is just a markup language which is used to develop a web layout or a structure of a web. Here we can see it is used to define the structure and layout of a web page, and the file extension for the HTML is .html or .htm. Next slide, please. HTML5 is the upgraded version of HTML4. It is recently coming. In 2006 it was introduced by WG and W3C. And W3C is Worldwide Web Consortium, which can be called as W3C, and WG. HTML5 will be the new standard of HTML, XHTML, and HTML DOM. The previous version of HTML came in 1999, and this new version has come in 2006 with the cooperation of WG and W3C. Consortium, and WG basically was working with the web forms and applications, and this W3C was working with XHTML 2.0. With the coordination of these two, W3G and W3C, they are decided in 2006. They decided to get with the new application. New markup language HTML5 with new inline elements, with new structural elements, with new semantic elements, with new input tags, so that they can give the world a best efficient web page with a very good structure and with a user friendly application. Next slide, please. Now the next slides will be discussed by my friend Koti.
Yeah. Thank you, Chana. Let us see the history of the HTML5. The history of the HTML. In the year 1992, the HTML is first defined. Why? Because it makes life easier for the web browsers. Okay, in the 1993, this HTML has an extension giving some physical layouts and fill-out forms and tables and mathematical calculations. Physical layouts means the appearance of the web page, and fill-out forms. You already know what about the fill-out forms and tables in the web page and the mathematical calculations. It is upgraded to HTML 2.0, it's a version. After that, in the year 1996, HTML 3.2 is evolved. In 1997, HTML 4.0 is upgraded and separate structures and presentation with style layouts, means borders, colors and font styles and colors of the fonts. In the year 1999, HTML 4.1, it's a slight modification of the HTML4 only. After that, in the year 2000, XHTML. XHTML means it's an extensible hypertext markup language. There is a difference between HTML and XHTML. The difference is a case sensitive. XHTML is. The code has to be written in only small letters. And let us take an example. If you take the code, if we declare the italic and bold, first the bold is declared and after that italic is declared. we have to close the first italic. After that only we have to close the bold in HT in XHTML. Whereas we can close anywhere in HTML. Okay, in the year after that, in the year 2002, it has a number of versions in XHTML also. In the year 2003, the new HTML5 is invented. I mean, it's an upgraded for the HTML4. It provides many forms and features using XForms 1.0 is introduced. Next slide. These are the new elements in HTML5. New document type and cassette, and new structure, new inline elements, and new dynamic page support, and new form types, new elements, and remove some of the elements in the web page. Next slide. Let us see one by one. It's a HTML5 doc type. It is used. It has to be declared for every web page. Why? Because it is an instruction for the web browser that in which version it has been written. I mean, in which version of the HTML the web page is written. So we use doc type HTML. Then the character set of HTML. The character set of HTML is used to mean which character type is used in the font style in the web page. So we use this type of character set HTML. I mean, this is a new structure. Let us see one by one. These are the tags, session, header, footer, navigation, article, aside, and figure. I mean, session tag. It is used to declare the chapters and header section, footer section, and other elements in the session tag. Header and header. It is used for the headings of the web pages, and we can declare the subheadings also in header and header session, and the links for the navigation. And after that, footer session. You already know about the web pages. If you come to the bottom of the web page, there will be a copyrights, right? That is the footer session. I mean, if you want to see in every page of this, we can declare it as a header and a footer. And then the navigation. Navigation means if you click the tab in a web page, we will go to the next web page. I mean, it is linked to the next website. So we use navigation tag to link this two web pages. And article. This is independent. I mean, it doesn't depends on any other of the tabs. So it is independent and self-defined. So we can declare it as an article tag. Then SI. This SI and article tags are linked. Why? Because this SI tag is a tabular it's a tabular form for this article. And the figure. This figure tag is used to draw the squares, circles, and some of the drawings. We use this figure tag. New inline elements and dynamic support. Let us see first new inline elements. Mark. The mark tag is used to highlight the text in the session. After that, the time. The time is declared maybe in the 24-hour clock. It is used to update the time and date. Let us see Facebook. We can see if we want to remind the birthday reminders, we will give the option that certain name and date. So it will take a part in that. Okay. Then the meter. This meter tag is used for the scalar measurements. I mean, it is used only for fractional values only. It's the progress. The progress tag is used to see to know the progress of the certain task. So we use the progress task. Let us see some dynamic page supports. Let us see the details. Details means, if you want to see the details of a certain tab, if we just place the cursor on that, separate window will be open. It gives the details. So we use the detail tag. And data grid. Data grid is one of the basic type one of the new element in HTML5, and the menu tag is used to give the list of the commands and list data. And then command. This command is used to invoke the web pages. We use the command, and these are some of the new elements in HTML5. The remaining tags will be continued by Mr. Ramkumar.
HTML5 supports all the standard formats. Other than the standard formats, in HTML5 we add few more formats. Those are date and time local, date, month, week, time, and number, range, and URL. apart from new elements are added into the HTML5. They are canvas. Canvas is an element in which you can draw, in which it gives drawing space in your JavaScript. Whereas, as well as you can add video in the HTML5 and the audio as well. In HTML5, there are a lot of elements which have been removed from the standard versions. Those are Ackerman, applet, basefront, big, center, directory, font, frame set. These are all nowadays not used in HTML5. Well, because the HTML5 uses newer version which has capabilities to newer version. In HTML5, there is a new description wherein other forms we need to add quotes, but in HTML5 we do not add quotes. We directly give the description of the picture or any image, and then we add it directly to the HTML5. Well, the standard email inputs are document type. We need to declare the document type correctly, and the HTML language, and then the form action, the body of the language, body of the page, and then the email. The input email ID should have a minimum elements of @ and dot. This will take the email input correctly, and it is supported by the browser. And the standard media formats also we should declare the document type, HTML body, and the video size, the size of the video, the width and height of the video. If you don't declare the size of the video, the document type, then the browser is not going to support the HTML5. Then it also adds the audio tags. The audio tags are the most important one. We should declare the same as the document type, the HTML, the body of the HTML body, and the song, the name of the song, and the controls, the size of the song and the controls. If you don't give the description of the body of the language correctly, then the browser is not going to support the audio element. The next slides will be explained by Mr. Akhil.
These are some of the tags we use in the HTML 5 to design a web page. First of all, the article view, it is used to define an article in the web page. And the next one is aside new, which defines each and every content in the page, which is located aside each and every content. And next tag is audio, which defines the sound which is present in the web page. And the next canvas, which defines graphics in the web page, which is designed in the web page. And the next command, which defines the command button in the HTML5. And data list defines the drop down list in the page. And the tag details, which defines the details of an element which is designed in the web page. And the tag dialog, which defines the dialog in the HTML5. And the word embedded is used to define external interactive content or the plugins which are present in the web page. And the tag figure, which defines the media content which are available in the web page. And the tag footer, which defines the footer section in the page, which are explained by quoting. The copyrights and everything is defined in the page, in the footer. And the header, which defines the header section in the top of the page. And the tag H group, which defines the information about the section in the document. Whole content is defined in the H group. And the tag keygen, which generates the key in a form. And the tag mark, which defines the mark text in the page. The word meter is used to measure the within a predefined range the size of the page.
And the word is used to define the navigation links which are present in. We can by clicking the links we can redirect it to other pages. The word output which define some types of output in the page. The word progress which defines the progress of a task in the page. The word RP which is used in Ruby annotations to define what to show browsers that not to support the Ruby elements. The word RP which defines the explanation to Ruby annotations. Ruby is used to define the Ruby annotations. Section which defines the section in the web page. And the word source is used to to define the media sources which are present in the web page. And the word time defines the date and time in the page. And the video which defines the video in the page. Then it should be continued by Mr. Chair.
And obviously we have many more advantages in the upgraded versions. So we here come with the 10 major advantages of HTML5. As it is a new version of HTML4, it has many advantages. And so there's mutuality and cleaner markup with improved code and some elegant forms of web application. Web page will be with very elegant form, with an elegant structure, with an efficient structure, and it will have consistency with the improved accessibility. It will fulfill the everything. I mean, need of the web application. And offline application cache, client-side database, geolocation support. These are all the major advantages of HTML5. And major differences between HTML4 and HTML5 here. Some elements like NME header were not present in the HTML4. Now in this we have them. And there are all some lack of rules parsing, so it is difficult to handle some errors. It is very easy to handle errors in the HTML5. And no multimedia supported without third party, here in which we can drag the video, audio, and it is a very user-friendly version of HTML because we can drag the video from directly to desktop to the web page, and we can drag audio audio source to directly, we can drag them onto the web page from the desktop or from any other file, we can drag them, and it was not available. It contains some attributes like control menu, spelling checks, and everything. And next, these are all the websites using HTML5. YouTube is using, and Google is using, and every other companies are using. Even Cisco is using HTML5 for the sales application site, and for the only some of the browsers. But only some of the browsers will support HTML5 features currently. And next. These are the browser support of HTML5. It is not yet an official standard. There are no browsers have full HTML5 support, but all major browsers, Safari, Chrome, and Firefox, Opera, and IE continue to add new HTML5 features to their latest versions. Because you know every company or every browser companies will add their new features. Because they want the public to view, get into their browsers. So it is, even all of them are using HTML5 new features. And currently, only Apple Safari is fully HTML5 ready. And Mozilla Firefox 3.5 supports the new coding, but is not 100%. That's it. If you have any questions, you can post your questions in the blackboard, like discussion board. That's it. Thanks from our side.
Thank you.
Thank you.